sawmill left. The state did find a set of plans for the sawmill, the way it was built originally in 1824, and they reconstructed this sawmill exactly the way it was in 1824, minus about 8 foot of sled and track going that direction, which meant they could have cut an 8 foot longer log than what I've got on here right now. If we cut a 20 foot long log and up to 24 inches in diameter, and it cut approximately 2,000 lineal feet of lumber per day. Not board feet, lineal feet. If I was cutting a 24 inch diameter log, every foot saw cut, I'd be cutting 2 board feet. In its day, when it was running, these flat stops that are on my sled were not there at the time. There was a series of holes across the sled and a peg on both ends that went into a hole. One was for a 1-inch thick board, the next one over was about a 2-inch board, the next one a 3, the next one a 4, up to 6 inches wide. I know if you've been in the mill, you've seen some of the beams that are up in there, and they're pretty good size. And they would have cut probably out of a 24-inch log. The way the saw operates, down in the pit over here is what's called an undershot wheel. The wheel for the grist mill itself is an overshot wheel. The overshot wheel, the water comes over the top and fills up the buckets. The inertia from the wheel starting takes very little water after that to keep it running. Just enough to fill some of the buckets partially and just keep it in a constant motion. The undershot wheel takes a lot more water, generates a whole lot less horsepower. Mill wheel generates about 25 horsepower. Our overshot wheel generates about 9. Also down in the pit is what's called a water wheel. What the water wheel does, it's connected to a shaft that goes across in front of my driveway. I've got a leather-covered wheel.